Hello viewers, in this video we'll be taking a look at this Delta Electronica power supply. I have already undone the screws at the top, which is all that is required to take the top off, and we'll be taking a look inside shortly. It features these flip out feet that make it easy to read the display when it is on the bench. I got this unit second hand and I decided to take a peek inside before I started using it. And I noticed that there were two things that weren't exactly as they should be. While I fixed both of them already, I have come up with a slight improvement that hopefully rules out one of these issues from ever happening again. Taking a quick look at the back here, we've got our mains input, earth bonding post and analog programming connector. The first thing that we're greeted with is this nice conformally coated PCB. Everything is nicely tied down, everything is nicely in place, even the caps are conformally coated, and everything just looks like it's fabricated to a very high quality standard. However, I have found some things that, in my opinion, could have been done a little bit better. This Y-class capacitor had one of its pins broken in half, and luckily there was 3 to 5 millimeters of pin left on that capacitor, so I was able to bend it over and solder it back in place. The pins that we're looking at over here belong to the front panel indicator LEDs that display if the power supply is in either constant voltage or constant current mode. If we take a look from the inside, we can see there are no mechanical means that hold this LED securely in place. It is just poking through the front panel and the manufacturer relied on the electrical connections to keep it in place. Now I don't know what happened to this power supply before I got it, but as a result of that and possibly some abuse, the pins from the right hand side LED were actually shorted out. And that is of course seen from the front panel. As you can clearly tell, I've already put some insulating sleeving around one of the pins of that LED, and I'm going to do that for the left-hand side LED as well in this video. Now it was just a matter of finding out which pin was the most convenient one to insulate, and that happened to be the pin closest to the panel meter, as it only had one connection going to it and no other wires were near that I could possibly damage while soldering. Being careful with some pliers, I managed to unsolder one of the pins, and whilst doing so, I momentarily forgot about the camera, and thus my hand is in the way whilst doing so. And of course, I couldn't really do it that any other way, because that hand would be blocking my own view. But it's nothing really hard to do, just grab hold of that pin and pull it slightly, and there it is. Here I am carefully straightening out that pin with pliers just a little bit to ease placement of that insulating sleeving. Take some careful fiddling to get this on this pin. And we're done. Looking from the top, we can see that it completely covers that pin from the back of the LED to the end of its pin. And now to solder it in place. Here I thought I've had it soldered correctly, but upon touching it up to make the solder joint look nice, it pinged loose again. So I had to re-solder it. Okay, now that is it soldered for the second time, and let's make sure that it looks like a proper joint. And again, my video taking skills aren't the best here, but as you can see, that looks like a nice fluid proper joint. Now all there is left to do is see if the indicators still work after that solder job. It looks like they do. Dear viewers, as always, thank you for watching this video till the end. If you have a comment, you're more than welcome to leave it down below. Also, don't forget to leave a like if you like this video, and please consider subscribing if you want to see more of my videos in the future.